These are the newly grown snake plants that I have grown from the leaves. The old leaves are still inside the soil. Earlier, these cuttings were growing in water. Instead of growing roots, the bottom part started decaying. Probably I did a couple of mistakes, but water propagation method works. In this, I want to share my experience in growing snake plants with leaf cuttings. Where did I do wrong? What did I learn from that mistake? These experiences will surely help you to grow snake plant cuttings both in water and soil. So what am I going to discuss? Between soil and water propagation, which method is good to grow? How many days does it take to grow? And how can you make it grow faster once it has roots? With all these points at hand, let's continue. Snake plants are used to accent internal decor because their leaves remain tall and upright, but sometimes one or two leaves bend down. These drooping leaves can be used for propagation. With one leaf, you can make many plants. You adopt this plant for its look, that is for spooky leaves. Don't cut a leaf here. If you cut it here or here, with time the cut parts turn brown and the plant loses the credit. Always cut a leaf here at ground level. With this, the shape of the plant looks perfect. You can cut this leaf into many pieces and use them all for propagation. I am marking the upper part as I keep on forgetting the lower part. So by mistake, if I put it in the reverse direction, this cutting will not grow. So it is important to remember the upward direction. Half of these cuttings I will grow in water and rest in the soil. Last time my experience to grow in water was bad. After a few days of putting the cuttings in water, the lower part became slimy. As soon as I noticed, I removed the water inside part and put the cuttings into the soil. A couple of things I experienced were wrong. First was the amount of water. So how much water should you add to the cuttings? Well, the water label should be that where the cutting tip can touch only. Adding more than this label is not essential. Second mistake was not cleaning the cuttings timely. So whenever you cut a leaf of snake plant, you will notice its juice. Once all the cuttings are inside water, it becomes a turbid due to the juice and invites mold or fungus. So regularly you need to check the cuttings, you need to change the water and clean the propagation container. To clean the cuttings, use your fingers to rub and remove the slime. The next mistake was to keep the cuttings at a dark place. That was the major one I did. Cuttings that are growing at a dark spot delay in rooting and invite fungus as well. All the plants, even cuttings, need light to grow. So choose a spot that has ample bright light for it. The rooting process will not happen overnight. So all you have to do is follow all the steps and check in your cuttings regularly. Always it is safe to take a good length of cutting. Between the process, if you think the cuttings are not doing well, cut the rotten part. You can still grow roots with a leftover cutting. That time use cocopeat or soil for propagation. The same thing happened with these cuttings while growing in water. They did not grow, so I transferred them to the soil before time. Now all are growing nicely. When I say soil, means garden soil only. Don't mix any compost during propagation. Compost generates heats that is not safe for a cutting. Once it has roots and grows further, you can use your regular potting mix during transplantation. If your cuttings are growing in the soil, it doesn't mean you will water frequently. spare the cuttings from this habit, water it once in a week, yet a condition applies. That is when you feel the absence of moisture in the soil. Follow this regime to protect the cuttings from being rotten away. Now you can decide between soil and water to grow. Both the methods are easy and convenient. But for me, to grow in soil is the easiest one, as I don't have to wash the cuttings or containers and change the water daily. When we grow cuttings, we urge to check frequently. That is human tendency, our curiosity to check or notice the growth. But it will not grow overnight. It may take a month or more to become a fully grown plant. First, these cuttings will take time to form roots. Once the roots are there, cuttings grow faster. So if you want to see your cuttings grow, stop being a guard to it. Don't pull away the cuttings to check whether roots are grown or not. So how will you check whether roots are grown or not? New pups like this will grow next to the leaves. Try to keep the cuttings at a brighter place. Once pups are grown, they will grow comparatively faster than the plants that are growing inside the room. One more thing you need to know. With the leaf propagation method, you may not get the same variety of plants. It may grow as a different variety. To grow the same variety, you need to grow it by dividing the rhizomes. Example, this is a fully grown snake plant with more than one rhizome growing inside. The new plant grows sideways from the rhizomes, so you can separate this part and grow it in another container. This is how you can make many snake plants from a single leaf or a plant. This is a wonderful plant for those who don't know about gardening. Start with this plant if you want to start gardening for the first time. You can easily maintain it. I hope all the said information will help you to grow this plant successfully. Please add your comments and share your experience with me. I'll be happy to get your suggestion as well. Thank you so much for watching this. I'll be back with a new video very soon. Till then, take care.